a destra, mm-hmm. una punta alta, che è il campanile più alto di Assisi, che è la chiesa di Santa Chiara. Mm-hmm. Si distingue male, è sull'estremità di destra.
She said that we can also see the church of St. Clair from here. You see the higher bell tower there?
Yes.
This probably is the bell tower of Santa Chiara, which is the higher bell tower in Assisi.
Right.
In this moment, in this place, there is an office, but the intention is to give back this place to its old memory for tourists and people that love Francis to know about this place. And I believe this place is very important because tell a very interesting story. And the story is that In 18 January 1200, a noble of Sassorosso, Giraldo di Gislerio, asked the priors of Perugia to become a citizen of Perugia. This way, its properties in Collestrada, between Perugia and Assisi, were going to be submitted to the comune, city-state, of Perugia. This way, Assisi was losing all rights on Girardo's lands. This means that this was what started the fight between the two towns. In fact, at that time, it was an habit to take advantage of the conflicts between the city-state to revenge one's own rights and save the properties. This conflict started a war between Perugia and Assisi. It was a cruel war to which the young Giovanni di Bernardona, later known as St. Francis from Assisi, participated. He was the son of a rich merchant and had the same desire to conquer, typical of the so-called period, Era Comunale, when the power was in the hands of the city-states. In the conflict, Francis and his companions had been recluded for a whole year in the prison of Perugia, this prison. The Saint's biography by Celano, Vita Seconda, reminds us, and these are the words of Celano, in a sanguinary war, Francis was kept prisoner together with many others. But while his companions were sad and miserable for the situation, Francis jubilates in God and doesn't care of the chains. Afflicted, his companions complain of his joy, thinking he is getting crazy. But Francis answers in a prophetic tone, "Di che cosa pensate che io gioisca? Ben altro il mio pensiero. Un giorno sarò venerato come santo in tutto il mondo. Why do you believe I'm happy? One day I'll be venerated as a saint all over the world." This way, Francis received enlightenment about his future sanctity in the prison of Perugia.
Francesco è venuto in questa piazza e probabilmente ha iniziato in questi luoghi la sua trasformazione da uomo che partecipava a conflitti a uomo di pace. Oggi siamo qui per ascoltare le sue parole, la sua voce, riascoltarlo e interpretare ancora con straordinaria contemporaneità le sue parole.
Francis came here to this piazza to bring peace, from conflict to peace, and nowadays we are still in this piazza to try to listen to his words and to interpret his words in a contemporary way.
Il pensiero di Francesco è di una straordinaria attualità.
The thought of St. Francis is an extraordinary actuality.
E Perugia, oltre che Assisi e tutta l'Umbria, ne sono interpreti contemporanei, con l'incontro tra culture, tra religioni, lanciano un messaggio al mondo di pace, di convivenza e di dialogo tra popoli e religioni.
And Perugia and Assisi, with all of the region, express this thought of St. Francis to bring peace among all people and all religions.
Noi siamo orgogliosi di avere degli amici oltreoceano.
We are very proud to have friends at the other side of the ocean.
Con i quali siamo legati dalla passione per il pensiero e la figura di Francesco. Questo consolida ancora il nostro rapporto di amicizia.
And this of course is mentioned in the Night of St. Francis with Angela Liotto, and he is very honored to have this brotherhood with the Knights of St. Francis and Angela working together on the same goal of bringing to the world the words of St. Francis.
Grazie. Thank you.
Adesso io la taglio.
And we wrote here the famous encyclical, the Rerum Novarum. Yes, yes. So.